what is rebirth. It so happened that I was in America, and three of my colleagues together we went to one American executive's house, executive's office. He said, executive said, you Indians believe in karma theory. Do you people sitting in front of me, do you believe in karma theory? Our friends got rattled because they are not sure whether karma theory is at all. Okay. So they said, no, 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 we don't believe in karma theory. Some Indians believe in karma theory. They started giving some vague answers. Then the American executive said, my wife is a very strong believer in karma theory. Okay, these guys got rattled again. Now, his wife believes in karma theory, we Indians don't know about karma theory. Now, how many of you believe in karma theory? Can you please raise your hand? Okay. So now, that's why I'm asking, belief and reality, I'm trying to come to that. So now it's a question of belief and reality, right? So the karma theory, let us understand this karma theory. Okay? So first let us understand, how many of you can make a good cup of coffee? Making a good cup of coffee is a good karma for all of you? Huh? Especially for the husband, or I don't know, rarely husband will do for wife, good karma. Okay? Doing a good cup of coffee is good karma for all of you? Yes or no?
Yes.
So any action is a karma?
Yes.
Any intention is a karma?
Yes.
Any intention is a karma? I want to make a good cup of coffee for my wife, but I don't do it. It's a good intention. Still it's karma?
Yes.
So action, thought is all karma. Do you agree?
Yes, huh?
So now any karma is like a seed which you sow in the ground. Soil. The seed will become sprout. Sprout will give fruits, and one fruit will give many fruits. Right? So, how many, all of you make a good cup of coffee, right? Sure?
Yes,
sir. Let us find out who makes a good cup of coffee. Thank you.
to reach me.
Besides these, say you had no water or no cooking stove.
a good cup of coffee?
Huh? You make a good cup of coffee? Sure. See, the karma is not what you do. Karma is what your understanding is. Okay? The understanding that I do a cup of coffee is a wrong understanding. A cup of coffee is being made through me is the right understanding. Okay, it is like this. Typically in a office, no? There are 10 people work. So they make a the result comes. And the boss comes and goes and tells his boss that I made this. And he qualifies for a promotion. Then what will happen to you? All the guys, some 4 or 5 people put resignation. Okay? So what is happening to you? Karma is not what you do. Please understand. This is a wrong understanding of karma theory has gone in. Karma is not what you think. Karma is your wrong understanding that you do. The totality of existence, you are part of that, you are doing it. The totality of your existence is called God. Okay? So you are a partner with God to make a cup of tea. That you forgot. That's the karma. Are you getting what I'm saying? So without a tea bag coming from the market, you cannot do a cup of tea. The tea came because it grew on the plant. The plant cannot grow without the earth. Earth cannot be there without the sun. Sun cannot be there. Without pouring rain, sun, the plant cannot grow. Okay? Sun cannot be there without a galaxy. That means to make a cup of tea, the entire universe is participating with you. Okay? Now if you take credit, I made a cup of coffee. Then universe will say, okay, you suffer the cup of karma. You are understanding what I am saying? See, can you make a cup of coffee?
As he said, only when I have the whiskey.
And all that is called totality. Where does it start? Cup of coffee requires a coffee plant. Coffee plant requires earth. Earth requires rains. Rains requires sun. Sun requires galaxy. And now this totality is called Brahmanda, the universe. And Brahmanda is called God. Now without participation from God, can you make a cup of coffee? And you claim that, that's why you got karma.
Claiming is karma.
The claiming is karma, not doing. Do you understand?
How is karma and cause and effect?
We'll come to that. Cause and effect will tell that, right? First you understand the karma. We'll get to karma and the birth and death. Then we'll get cause and effect. So is it clear? The totality is participating in every action. When the flower blooms, the whole universe is celebrating. You thought you are celebrating. When your child is born, it is a product of the whole universe. It's not your product, your child. Entire universe is participating in all the activities, and that's called the action of the universe. You are also required. Okay, without you, that action doesn't happen. But doesn't happen because of you. Without you, there's no action possible. But it's not because of your action is happening. But you claim that because of me this happened, that's called karma. Can you understand the difference? Any questions, sir?
So which means I carry those thoughts in my mind. Those vasanas continue.
Okay, now, because you don't acknowledge the totality participating, you are becoming a part of the karma. If you understand the totality is participating, where is the karma? It's entire, everything in the universe is participating through you. Where is the karma? That's why in the Mahabharata war, more than 50 lakh people were killed. 50 lakh people. A war, massive war. In that massive war, actually people from Afghanistan and other countries participated. People, actually there was the First World War. So we don't understand what is First World War. First World War happened about 5,000 years back. 5,038 years back. Only in the recent World War we have known. And in the recent World War, less number of people got killed compared to First World War. Okay, so in that war, Sri Krishna was there overseeing every killing. Okay? But not one point of karma to him. Because he is representing the totality. He is clear. This is required for the totality. The moment you say, I do, the selfishness comes into picture. And the moment you say that, the karma will complete. Forget about karma with the totality. Okay, in your office, four people do the work and you take the credit. The karma will come bang you. And what about now? You are not giving credit to the whole universe. Will it not bang you?
Huh? Left and right.
Left and right bang you. That's not karma. Do you understand karma? Huh? So, what's happening is every action of ours is the action of the universe. That's why Shri Krishna told in Bhagavad Gita, I'll tell you, repeat. Nimitta matram bhava sadhya sachin. Oh Arjuna, you are just an instrument, okay, of the totality. Without the instrument, the work doesn't get done. But work is not because of the instrument. Right? Now the instrument has started claiming that I am doing, and that is called karma.
That is not karma.
Huh?
That is not karma, sir.
Which one?
That is instrument. I am the instrument making a copy.
That's not karma. See, if you are instrument of Bhagavan, there is the karma.
Your
individuality goes. Boss. The whole universe operates through you. Where is the karma?
When
that person enjoys the thing. Huh? He is enjoying or he is aware that. No, the enjoyment is another karma. So he has to be understand that he is the universe is enjoying through him. Actually this whole concept of I is a misnomer. You got what I'm saying? Did you understand what is karma clearly? Anybody has a question about karma? Yes or no?
So no I, no karma.
There's no I anytime. The anytime you can't do one cup of coffee, okay, without a permission from the plant. Alright? So now you say I did the coffee, then you are separate from the plant. That illusion of I is creating the karma. There's no.
We all cause and remedy.
Sorry?
We all cause and remedy.
Yes, yes. It's a totality. You don't say cog in the wheel, you are a part of the totality. In that totality, you have a role to play. Okay? Without you, that work cannot get done. But it doesn't get done because of you. So this understanding is missing in us. We think that I start doing, I do. So that is called karma.
Because of all other things you have done something.
No. You are a team player. This is a team. It's not because of them you are doing. You are a part of the universal team. Right? In a football match, every player has a role. Okay? The match cannot be done without the player. But match is not because of the player. There is a?
Everybody in the team, like in the example of team, the plant, the particular plant, all the structure of plant,
right.
And the temperature at the plant, and the sunlight at the plant, and whatever, finally the instrument making it, all that, finally a product comes out. It's all, but every team is not the same particular.
That is right. What I'm saying, that is a, you are a part of that, making you a fine customization.
Just do the work.
You are doing the work. If the purity, she makes the tea and you make the tea, there is a difference because you are a part of customization service. But you are a part of it, not yours, independent of it.
Yes.
Clear?
Sir, understanding of that I am part of the thing, I take the tea or whatever. And I am understanding that I only did the tea.
Yeah.
How the karma will affect
us? So, I only did it, is it right understanding, wrong understanding?
Wrong understanding.
That means you created an I in you. You created separate ourselves from the universe. Okay? And this entity I starts claiming that I am separate and I am independent. And I am responsible for doing the tea. If you are responsible for doing the tea, you are responsible for karma also. It's a reciprocal.
This being the case, when I drink tea and I say tea is good, here also I have brought in subjectivity.
This tea is good, actually you have to understand.
I drink it and I taste it.
That will take, I drink it and taste it, I will come to that now. I am coming to that now. I am only just now action part. Now tasting part I will tell you. So, experiencing part I will tell you.
I don't make tea.
Huh?
You don't make tea at all.
You don't make tea at all. So, you don't make any karma.
Whatever
was available, and made one nice cup of coffee. Huh.
Okay, at the same time, suppose you don't utilize it for a good cause.
No, no. See, when a good cause or bad cause, the universe participates. The good cause or bad cause is not coming from the universe, it's becoming from the individual. His understanding. Right? He sees I am separate from the individual, he starts becoming selfish. That's a good cause or bad cause. Are the totality of universe is participating for everything? No. The trees, the sun is giving light, sunlight, not for itself. Sun is giving to trees. Tree is giving oxygen to others. Fruits are given to others. The river is flowing, not for itself. The clouds are showering, not for itself. Only human being becomes selfish, I. And that I is formed because of the action, and that's what I'm trying to tell you. And that's the cause of the karma. Huh? Got it? So the moment you start understanding that every action is a divine action, I am an instrument of that, I am required to do that, but I am not doing it. It is being done through me. Huh? Illa, this is not again wrong. Again, namma karma bantu. Nimma karma yak bartha endu helthidenu nanu.
Karma is not fate.
Karma is not fate.
Okay. Every time I think, I am doing it, I get reinforced.
Yes. And that reinforcement is actually the seed of karma. The criminal is because he has a strong I, separate I. He is thinking, he doesn't know that he is totally disparticipating. If totally disparticipating, why will you kill somebody? If you are me, why will you go and kill you? He has become criminal because he is separate, seeing you separate from you.
There's one more example. I can make a difference.
Yeah.
What is that?
So that I can make a difference is also I. I can make a difference is I. No, no, I'm saying first how the karma seed has come. The ego has come. The ego has a sattvic ego, rajasic ego, tamasic ego. Tamasic ego is destructive. Rajasic ego is active. Sattvic ego is good karma. Okay? Now, whether sattvic or rajasic or tamasic, all of them are handcuffs. Good karma will help you to evolve.
I don't see that. It's a good work is going on. My contribution is going to make something better.
No, no.
I won't do
there
it.
Is no question about you making intention. There's no question about that. The question is not about my intention. You are required to do that happen. You are exactly required. I'm not questioning that. Question is, what is your attitude in doing?
Because of me, it is being.
So the moment you say, because of me, you are doing. No, no. This is you listen carefully. No action is done by you. Without you, no action can be done. The universe is acting through you. You are an instrument of universe. Because of you, it is not happening. Okay? With you, it's happening by the universe. Now, what's happening is the moment you say, you have good intention. Okay? Now, good intention, how did it come? It just got generated inside. It came from the divine inspiration. So now you are separated out. So then the moment you separate out, that becomes karma. That gets called good punya. The moment you get punya, you get swarga or heavenly planets. The moment you start understanding the totality of existence, you start becoming free from the punya and papa. Good karma is required, no doubt about it. But what attitude to do karma is required. That is actually karma yoga. Naham karta, harineva karta. God alone is doing, I am the instrument. That attitude should be there. Others become social service and it enables you to go to swarga and heavenly planets.
Work for work's sake.
No, work as a service. Work for work's sake is monotonous. It is a karma, I have to do work. You do work as a service. Service to whom? The totality, Lord. Okay? It's a save of the universe. Work for sake, never do it. Work for the sake of service, you do it. Whom are you serving? What you are giving is not, let's say I make a cup of tea and give it to her. Okay? Actually, I am not giving it to her. I am giving it to divine child in her. The divine child is part of the universe. So you are giving a cup of tea to somebody is also a service. The moment you say I am giving a cup of tea and making it favorable to her, that's a karma again. Because you are cutting yourself from the totality. Separation is coming in picture. This is the cause of karma. Okay, your understanding of who is doing is the cause of karma, not doing the karma. With this understanding, sorry?
I was going to say, so the more I take you a share, I'm getting this huge psychological package. Which becomes a huge.
That is called karma. Okay? Doership is
contributes to the ego and makes the balloon.
That is the seed of karma. Is got the point? You are required to do that. You are required to do a good intention. You are required to do a good service. But it is not happening because of you. It is happening through you.
Now
Bhaktrata will take it. Right? Yes, sir?
Whatever we are required to do. If we do whatever we are expected to do as part of the overall, is that karma?
No. There's no karma because it's a power over.
If I say I did it, then it becomes.
No, you don't. I don't say I did it. Doesn't matter.
No, if I say, then it becomes.
It is not about saying. It's about understanding. Feeling. For everybody you say, I only did it because of me it happened, you say.
Yeah.
But what is your understanding?
Deep inside
you, what's happening? That is important. What you say to others, tomorrow you say, we go into office and say, okay, this job has to be done. The total universe power behind the job.
If it wants, let it do.
No, it doesn't work that way. For communication purpose, you follow the same protocol. But your understanding has to be corrected. Right? See, I'll tell you, please understand. Don't go and tell tomorrow I have understood karma theory and don't try to explain to anybody. They will get confused. Okay? Right? Please understand, many things I tell in the class, it's only for the people who come to the class because this can be misunderstood and misinterpreted. I'll tell you actual scenario what happened. Okay? So, I had a boss who was senior, who was actually 58 or 59, and I was at around 35, 34. So whenever he gets stressed, he will call me for a discussion so that I will calm him down. Okay? He feels that talking to me will relieve him. So one day he called me. I am too much stressed, Prabhu. Okay? This whole office, nobody is working, only I am working. Things are not moving at all. Okay, then I said, sir, he was drinking a cup of coffee. This actually whole inspiration come from him. Sir, this cup of coffee you are drinking. Okay? Suppose you are making a cup of coffee. Do you make a cup of coffee? Yes. Then I explained this thing. Then he got shocked. Oh, to make a cup of coffee, so many things are required. That means this office requires a totality of people. Even if I am not working or working, the total support is required. So then he calmed down. I have to work with people, make them understand. Then he went home. That night he was very inspired. The totality, God is working through me. So he went home. And at night dinner, the wife brought us very special seat. Sweet. Okay? Special seat. Sweet. And he ate the sweet and didn't comment at all. The wife said, "Anyway, sweet chanaita, sweet is good." "Yeah, good." "Do you know why I made it?" "Yeah, it's nice." "Do you remember why? What is date today?" "Marriage anniversary." Okay? So then, you didn't even say good about it. Now he is applying my teaching to her. Okay? So she said, "Do you think you made the sweet?" Okay, that marriage resource, wow. What do you think I am? Okay, 40 years of marriage, that is 40 years of marriage. 40 years of marriage over, I don't have a single maid servant, I don't have a maid now, and I don't have a cook. and you know very well I am doing everything. I didn't bring it from the shop. And you are asking me, did you make the cover sheet? Then this guy got all day messed up. So then he said, see, look, okay? See, look at the sky. The moon is there. Sun is there. Okay? Because of that, we are doing small. 5 days it took him to convince her, calm down, calm down. So whatever teaching is there, not for giving it to anybody. Unless you become guru, don't teach anybody. Okay? Right? I can comfortably say this because I have a clarity and somehow you are stuck here and you are listening to me. But the moment you start telling to others, you are in trouble and those people are also in trouble. Because whatever I am telling in this class is completely fundamentally out of society thinking or even religious thinking. Okay?
Sir, if the sweet is not good, what happens, sir?
Sweet is not good. So you say that I did it, you'll feel bad. If you say that God, you have made a bad sweet to me today, so the God will feel bad. Tomorrow you'll make it good sweet. That's one thing. The God will take a larger part of the karma.
But whatever it is, you have to praise your wife.
Yes.
And
like you said, let's say the final product is not good enough. So basically there, then you have to bring in compassion.
No, no, no compassion. See, the good or bad, see, once you understand, see, I'm just giving you an example, okay? So you are doing a service to your service. You are not treating, you are not working with your husband. You are actually working with the divine. Okay? Whether he has understanding or not, you have the understanding because you are totally you are offering something. Okay, right now, you know why I am conducting the class? Not because I want to get a name or fame or anything. I am serving you people. Okay, for me, you are the God. I am serving the universe through you. Okay? Now you say this guy teaching is not bad. I am saying, okay, fine, I'll correct it. Right? A customer says your service is not good, okay, what correction I have to do? Right? Tomorrow you are working in a company, customer says your product is bad, okay, then you say, you shout at the customer, is it? You say, okay, I need to correction, I'll improve it. So tomorrow you come back and say, Prabhuji, your teaching is not good enough, then I'll say, what correction I have to do? I'll do it. I have no good or bad, because I'm doing service, I'm not doing for myself. Right? So you will never feel bad.
So without understanding, there will be compassion.
It's not your compassion. Simple. Why should you feel bad? Right? If I feel that, oh, you people have to praise me or you have to give me money, then I will feel bad. But I am doing a service to the God. Then God says, this is not good, correct it. So it's an improvement, an opportunity for me to learn. Now improve, no? A feedback for me. Why should I feel bad? I don't know, I'm not even compassionate with God, okay? That's a very big thing for me. To be compassionate with God.
Sorry, another word for compassion, understanding.
So the whole understanding, the correction has to happen in what is karma, what is our role in society. The moment you understand this, all actions you do becomes dharma. It will never become karma. So you have to understand, when you don't do dharma, it becomes karma. Got it? So dharma means all actions in tune with the universal totality. Where is the karma for you? See, I'll give another example. A soldier comes and fights for the country. And he is killed. Okay? There's no choice for me, he gets killed. So, is it karma? Life is being sacrificed for the totality of the country and people. Now you say, no, you did bad karma, you killed an enemy. You did bad karma, you'll suffer. It doesn't happen that way. His attention is, yes, I am protecting. So his feeling is, he may not understand the universe and totality at all. He understands he is fighting for a larger cause. And that larger cause will not give him karma, because larger cause is the God. Where is the karma? The karma happens when you forget dharma. Dharma you forget, how you forget dharma? Because you don't understand you are part of the totality. The moment you are a part of the totality, every action is divine action, every thought is a divine thought, every step is a divine step. Where is the karma? Who told you about karma thing?
Sir, every step is a divine step, sir.
Huh?
But that fellow who killed him is also a divine
step. No, see, here the understanding, please understand, here we are not able, not there to correct somebody. Are you worried about your karma or his karma? His karma he has to correct with his guru or God. Here we are not there to judge anybody. Not even, you can't come go and tell your wife or son also. This is, you understand what's karma and become free. Now you want to go and teach him, you become a guru and teach him. But don't worry about karma or action of others. You ask the question, always ask the question, what I can do? I will give a cup of tea to someone and not to someone. That's fine. Nothing wrong in that because that's the role you are in. So if your role is to take the care of the whole country, you will do that. Whatever role the universe plays you, you do that.
So right? The thing is, I should not feel guilty that I did not give it to someone.
You don't have to, no, because your role is limited, no. Whatever your role, you do it well with the right attitude. Why worry about somebody else's role? If your role is to give tea to everybody, you will be posted in that position. The God will place you in that position. If your role is to take care of the whole country, you will place you as a prime minister next election. Just another few days away, right? Your role is to sit and hear, listen here. That's it. Do it well. At every time, the universe acts fairly and accurately. That's the point.
So how do we understand what is our role and beyond that?
We will find out that. Right? First, is this much clear? Any doubts are there what I said?
Is there
no good
karma
there? Huh?
If you are saying that karma means no dharma.
When you forget dharma, karma starts.
So there is not
a
good karma.
When you do dharma, there is no good karma or bad karma. You are dear to the God. See, when you are, good karma means punya, bad karma means papa. Right? The papa and punya, good karma, will come when I am the individual to one. When I am instrument of God, you become closer to God. So why you want karma? What is your purpose? You want to become get good punya and go to Sarga, or bad punya, bad karma and go to heaven, or come closer to the God. Right? The more you are involved in the more you are closer to God. Why you want to punya papa? That's the whole karma theory. Karmanne vadika raste ma faleshu kadachana. Do your action without expecting result. That's exactly what I'm trying to tell you in a different way. Why I have to do action without expecting results? Because I want to become closer to God.
That's also a direct path.
Huh?
If you say like that, that's also a direct path.
See, it becomes indirect path because people who teach that, they don't understand direct path. If I told you in this class, karmanne vadika raste, you will already have heard 10,000 times. But you didn't understand the intention of that. Right? I don't tell you. That's the preacher's job. A preacher is, do good karma, don't expect result. I am telling you why you should not good karma, why you should do like this. Then you will understand. Then now I don't have to tell. I will not tell you now. You do whatever you want, right? You'll never do karma. I am only giving inputs to you. Ultimately, it's your decision.
Sir, all actions are divine actions, sir.
Huh.
No, is it
okay, we'll find out now. Right now we'll find out. Right now we'll find out. I'll find out. I will not tell you. I'll show you.
I will not tell you.
I'll show you. You tell me whether it's divine action or not.
So
okay.
Never we need to ignore the dharma.
How can you ignore dharma?
That will lead to karma.
That's karma.
What
is dharma?
Dharma is all actions in tune with the universe.
All actions?
In tune with the universal law.
The role of the how do you deal with people? Now, I know so many people who have all these kinds of thinking. Like one lady who is part of her family, once said, I should take care of my children because at least the non-saiva karan and vayale akhi akhara.
Allappa, correcting her, is it responsible?
I keep away from such people.
Forget it. What I'm saying is correcting her is the responsibility given by God to you.
No.
No. Then why are you getting involved other? Taking care of your wife is your responsibility given to you.
No.
No.
How
So please understand what role the God has given to you. Do it well. Finished. There are so many million things are happening. Okay? If you have a role, God will tell you, do this. And he will give a question to you, do this. If you don't have a role, do what is given to you well. Simple.
If the result which is coming, if you don't have the result, I lose some loved one, I lose money.
Please understand, this universe, you say, this world, this whole thing is called a universe, you know? You know what is universe? Uni means one. One poem. One verse. Actually, from the universe, the university has come. Okay? University is a place for learning. So here you are not, here you are there to learn. If you, something you are doing is not in tune with dharma, some karma will come. So you learn from that. Okay, don't blame yourself. Offer that karma to Lord and learn from it. You have to always ask, what is the learning which I am doing from this? Improve on yourself. You lost money, so ask, what is the improvement I have to do? Right? For example, I will say, let's say, I am your customer, you are a travel salesman, right? Actually, I have not paid you the money. Okay, last trip, some money has to be paid. I didn't pay. So now, Shashi gets angry, customer is not paid. Prabhu, you are not paid. What kind of customer you are? So he loses the customer, next trip also is gone. So, what is Shashi to do? You have to learn. So what is the learning? So any business transaction, I need to take an advance and I need to follow up and collect the money. That's the learning. So the universe is there for us to learn from our karma, improve ourselves. Okay, and gradually drop the fruits of karma at the feet of the Lord. Finished. And do your role properly. That's called dharma. Whatever is given to you, do it well. Do it so well that universe appreciates. Yes, sir.
In universal dharma, so ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಈಗ ನೀರಿಗೆ ಹರಿಯೋ ಗುಣ ಇದೆ, ಬೆಂಕಿಗೆ ಸುಡೋ ಗುಣ ಇದೆ.
So, she is asking a question of dharma. See, dharma is confusion.
You are expecting the water to...
No, no, it's very, very simple. Dharma is a very, very simple concept. No. Don't worry about any complicated things, okay? Dharma is very, very simple. Okay, dharma is very damn simple. So, simple. Don't do to others what should not be done to you. Don't kill others because you don't expect to be killed. Don't hurt others because you don't like somebody hurt. Don't do to others what should not be done to you. Very simple principle of dharma. Okay? Do to others what you expect to be done to you. That's called service.
So when somebody hurts you, or you take the hurt, because at that point you are the mind angry.
Right.
Whatever. And it stays with you. But you don't react to that person. But you are carrying the psychological baggage with you for a long time.
Yes. So, what's your question?
In that case, you have not reacted. And you are not reacted, so you are not with the cycle. But still the cycle is within you.
No, what is the question? The question is what?
How do you get rid of the psychological baggage?
Don't get rid of it. Find out who you are. See,
exactly what I
think. Why are you actually? See, the whole concept of Indian spirituality, please understand, there are a lot of misunderstanding. Okay? Simple, this India has a great country. Okay? We have done research in the space, astrology, astronomy, Ayurveda, yoga, meditation, everything we have done. But there's one subject is missing in the Indian system, you know? That's called psychology. In what? Batteries.
All right, this handling is also
So what was the question?
So
you see, please understand, India, listen carefully, yeah. You imagine a country of civilization of 10,000 years, which has produced many, many great things, has never created a subject of psychology.
Maybe it is there in our scriptures, we haven't.
It is not there.
What is the reason? That was the reason for this.
I'll tell you.
Psychological revelation was not given.
See, I'll tell you why. Don't focus on the mind, but focus on the Atma. I will tell you why you don't focus on the mind. Focus on the Atma self. So there was a person. Okay. So he went to Guruji. Guruji, please teach me some meditation. Guruji saw this fellow. This guy can't sit for a long time. He said, Guruji. The Guruji said, why don't you go and take care of my cowshed? Okay, do some service. So 1 year this fellow takes off this thing and he gets frustrated. Guruji, teach some meditation. If you don't teach meditation, I'll go. Okay? The Guruji says, your mind is not ready for meditation, my dear. You are agitated. No, please tell me. Okay? The Guruji says, okay, I'll teach you one meditation, one mantra, secret mantra. One big secret mantra. This mantra I'll tell you, don't tell to anybody. Okay? And while telling this mantra, while chanting this mantra, you go and sit in a very silent place and chant this mantra for next 10 days. But one condition. Don't think of monkeys when you chant this mantra. Okay? So now this guy goes and sits for meditation. Mantra chants number one times. Suddenly one monkey is coming and sitting in this bag. Another monkey. One within room is full of monkey. Well, not monkeys actually, imagination. The mind, the nature of the mind is to go for what you don't do. So the moment is, I have to repair the mind. Mind will say, oh, repair me more. Don't focus on the mind.
Ignore the mind.
Go to Atma. Why are you bothered about the mind? That is the only reason in the whole of Indian civilization, which of 10,000 years, never created subject called psychology. Focus on the right thing rather than worrying about the wrong. Oh, have a lot of impressions. Why? You think of God. Chant God's name. P. Think of Atma. Become free. Oh, I want to repair mind. Then you are getting into a negative cycle. And there is no end to that, because mind is the impressions are many. Don't worry about the impression. Think of God and be free from mind. Think of Atma and become free. Why are you worried about mind? This is the reason. And please understand, the psychology today is a mess. The moment you go to a counselor, the counselor has his own impressions. And you have impressions. Now, earlier you had your impressions. Now you are taking your counselor's impressions also. Now you are 1 plus 1, 2, actually 4 also. His wife's impression also is coming to you.
Psychology is a superficial dimension.
That exactly I am telling you. Don't worry, ever worry about the mind. Worry about right thing. Right action, dharma. What I have to do, you think. What I have to achieve, think of God. God's name will purify you. Think of Atma, will purify you. Is it simple? Right? Ramana Shivoham. Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana
Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
So whenever you are disturbed about somebody, actually you are thinking of that person again and again.
It's a loop.
It's a loop mess. So the moment you are disturbed with somebody, think Ramana Shivoham. Think Om Namah Shivaya. Why are you getting in a negative cycle? Get into a positive cycle.
Don't keep that same loop deeper, just jump into another loop.
No. Why are you falling? Go up. Okay, now is the karma is understood clearly at all? Madam? Now you say what I have to perform in a given role. That also.
What is my role? So, how do I know that this is my role?
Don't worry about your role. The very, see, please understand, you know, everything is very, very clearly defined. There's no vague terminology there. Right now, you are sitting.